I will be playing mono green aggro in standard today, which is one of the decks that got some of the most help from Crimson Vow. Mainly it's Ascendant Backleader, which is one of the, or not one of the, it's the much needed high power one drop that this deck just desperately needed. Sentinel is not great. It's somewhat playable just because you really need to play something on turn one. Like if this deck just doesn't do anything in the first couple of turns, like it's not really, you know, it doesn't really make all that much sense playing aggro if you're not really doing anything in the early turns. So Sentinel into Pack Leader is a pretty big upgrade. I'm still playing one Sentinel, maybe even kind of want to play two because this deck just really needs to play something in the first turn. And even though it's not great because even if it does give you mana, it means your two drop is not attacking, but it still means that you can play Chariot on turn three, which is sometimes a pretty big deal. And my cat probably needs attention, but let's leave it for later. My sideboard is still a work in progress. That's mostly what I want to find out today. I like Snakeskin Veil in this format because there's a lot of red-blue decks. Snakeskin Veil. I want to play all of the same ones though. Snakeskin, this can go. Snakeskin, this can go. Inscription, some extra removal after sideboard. Brendan 7. I like to have them in the sideboard for the grindy matchups. Like sometimes it's just a really nice card to have. And after that, I don't really know. Like the mono green deck doesn't really have a great sideboard. That's the one of the issues. But hopefully we'll find out today if, you know, I'm missing something after sideboard. So that's why it's okay. My cat. He is okay. I promise you guys, he is fine. All right. Let's hope we're gonna be able to find a match. I don't know if you can hear that, but it sounds like he's being tortured. He's perfectly fine, just, you know, playing around the house. Yeah, this is like one of those hands. Like, I almost already don't really want to keep this. I mean, I think you kind of have to. Because you just have, you know, lands and spells that you can play on curve. But my hand is kind of one-dimensional, kind of awkward. Whenever you activate. Okay. I definitely want to actually. Wait. So if I had the 2-2 guy that untaps a 4 and a snowland, then I would definitely play that so I can play 2-2 drops on turn 2. But here it's actually better to play Pack Leader because you can still play Cobra plus a 2 drop next turn. So this is a better way to sequence things. Now they basically cannot kill my Cobra, or they cannot kill it before it gives me mana. So, well, that was the downside. I can draw into a 4 drop. I should also make sure that I play this first. I don't think I will be attacking. Green. Play you and pass. No attacks. Red, black, aggro. Okay. First strike. Both means this has to attack, right? Okay. I mean, a 5-5 would be pretty decent here. Okay, so you just want to put a counter on this? Sure. So I think I'm attacking with just Pack Leader. I could activate. I could activate Ranger Class and attack for 6. Although the counter only happens after the 3/3 trigger, so I'm not going to draw a card. I think it's just better to play my Chariot here plus Sentinel. Thing is, am I attacking or no? I don't think so. This is just it doesn't make any sense to attack. Green, play you. And we can pass. I mean, they can suicide this to make a 5-5, but I think I can just attack through it. Like, next turn I can play double ranger class, activate this, and just everything attacks. This dies, but I attack for something like 12 or whatever. 12, yeah, 12 is 12 exactly, actually. And I make an extra token, so I don't think they're actually going to be able to do that. Yeah. Chariot number two. So Ranger class. Or Ranger class activate. What's better? Actually, I think I just attack with Chariot first. It's gonna trade it something, but then I can play the second one, so. Maybe I should make it 5-5. Actually, wouldn't be the worst, because then they don't really have gray blocks. Yeah, I actually want to do this, I think. I'm gonna draw, and these can stay home. And the best they can really do, I think, is just double block the back leader with the 2/2s. Which is fine, I already got an extra card out of it, so it's not really a big deal for me. And the chariot's gonna continue getting me advantage. They just trade. That seems a lot worse than just blocking with these two. But maybe I'm missing something. I can play Mammoth. I can actually play both Ranger class this turn. Play Ranger class, then tap the one, and then I'm gonna have 3 2/2s on defense. I think that's okay. Red green. Tap you. Tap you, 4 2/2s actually. Play you. All right, that's a decent board. My only problem with monogreen is that sometimes you're just behind when you're on the draw, you don't have a one drop against like a white deck, you know, curving out on you or some other aggro deck really. And there's just nothing you can do. Like it's not a deck that really plays well from behind. So you can boast anytime, right? Boast. Okay. Anytime it's not a sorcery. Okay. So we can do this and double block one of the 2/2s. Let's see. Yep, you can make a 5-5. I'm gonna trade for one of the 3/3s. This dies to the other guy. Now they have a 5-5 in play. That can at best trade for my chariot. Question is, can I attack with everything? I can play troll, crew, and everything smashes. Unlikely I die on the backswing. Other option is double activate ranger class. Which is not the worst either, but I think troll is just strictly better. Crew you. Don't even need to attack with everything, but I think it's fine. Yeah, whatever. This is attacking or no? Yes, so I'm gonna make everything to power. Okay, first I target a token. And this is gonna be to power as well, so 6, 8, 10, 12. They can block a 2 power creature and not die. Then they go to 1. Yeah, apologies to everyone who read one of my previewing articles or card highlighting articles. I thought this card dealt damage to creature. So I was like, yeah, I mean, it's a clean answer to Talia. I know that's definitely going to see play. This card seems really good. Yeah, it turns out it doesn't actually shoot creatures. You can only shoot the opponent or a planeswalker, which makes this card a lot worse than I thought. It's probably still like okay-ish in some mono-red decks, just because it's going to be great against decks like, you know, blue-red or blue-black control or just any control deck, really. But against other creature decks, it's really bad. I don't know what this does. Create a 2-3 with Menace. That's it. Sure. I mean, I don't know. Maybe I'm missing something having double strike or whatever. I'll just block with one and attack with everything. Okay. Red-black. I think the inscription is pretty decent. The question is, how good is Snakeskin Veil? They didn't really target my creatures, but I assume they're going to have something after sideboard. All of these are great. What's my worst card? I think Ranger class is kind of bad, especially on the draw. I feel confident boarding them out. And I think I just want to bring in some Brandon 7. Like, 2 seems decent. I can bring in double inscription, maybe double veil, 1 inscription. Sure. I like Vren because I think they are going to have like a bunch of removal after sideboard, and it's a great card for grindy games. Let's go there. All right, Wally, what you got? Yeah, well, we have a Sentinel into a turn for Vren. That's okay. I can kill something with the Brawl. The standard Fatal Push, sort of. Opponent taking a mulligan and you having a 5 drop, you having a Planeswalker in your hand, and like a decent curve to get there is one of the better feelings when you play Constructed Magic during the opponent reveals. Sure. Would actually make sense for them to get rid of the pack leader, considering that that is going to speed everything up. Oh yeah, I think now I'm just attacking with the pack leader and playing Mammoth. I don't think I'm going to play Oddity. I could. Certainly could. But then I don't really have a great way to put this into play, and I'm going to miss the landfall triggers. So you attack. Play you and pass. All right, well, these are coming in. I'll attack with the pack leader as well. I think that's okay. Didn't have to do it because they can just double block it. But if that happens, I'm attacking for 9 or whatever. So they are kind of just dying anyways. The Faceless Havens are really what makes this deck work against the control decks, I think. Just, okay, well, I didn't expect that at all. But 4 life is not enough against the Faceless Haven. Well, that explains why they blocked the 4-4. Because it was more than 3 casting cost for the verdict. Green, blue, white, blue, green, actually. Something is telling me to play blue today. Probably unlikely to cast blue, black today. White or red. Okay, well, that's not happening either. I would like to play first. Oof. Man, I don't know. If I had a one drop instead of any of these cards, then I'm much more likely to keep because I just have a decent opening. And even if I don't do the third land, I can just activate Render Class. Keeping like this, if I draw the third land, it's a pretty good hand. Sure, let's keep. And this deck is playing a lot of lands. 24 lands. There's three Kazundu Mammoth. Like 27. Zombies, alright. Ooh, okay. Sometimes lucky. I think a Mulligan would have been perfectly reasonable too, because I don't really have, like, my hand is also kind of just all creatures. I don't really have any interaction. I don't really have any great way to, you know, do something about my opponent's board. But two lands on off the top makes things a lot easier. Okay. I mean, they're killing my stuff, but they're not really taking advantage of that. Pretty sure I want to go. So pack leader first, or does it matter? Enters the battlefield if you control opponent at 4 or greater when you cast. So it doesn't matter if you do it first or second. All right, your turn. The good thing about the green deck is that the creatures are just really big. If somebody plays removal spells against you, like, it's going to take a lot of them to actually grind you out, because first of all, you have Chariot, which is card advantage. If you're playing against 1-for-1 removal, you have cards like Old Growth Troll, which if they kill it, gives you more mana, then it brings another 4-4 back into play. So it's not really easy for them to deal with that. Does this trigger for both? It does. So they can trade and keep 2/2s in play. What's my play? I think I play the Oddity that bombs the pack leader, and then I just send everything in, including the Chariot, which I make from the tokens. Okay, so they get a 3/3 champion, which is fine. So how does this actually work? 7 mana, it's pretty good. I mean, I think I'm playing the Mammoth. Even if I don't draw the land, I still have mana to use for my double or Ender class, so it seems pretty good. Yeah, okay, now I just really want to draw the land, I think. Ooh, Brawl is interesting, but I can't really get rid of this without my other creature dying, but I can just set up for it pretty well. I can kill the champion. They fight, right? Oh wait, against an indestructible. Okay, never mind. That's a key interaction right there. Indestructible is great, because that also lets me get in for a great attack. I think I'm giving this guy indestructible, and then I'm crewing Chariot, and I'm activating Ranger class. So let's start with this. Killing the stinger. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So activate you. Crew. Actually, probably I'm gonna attack with everything actually. So crew you from these. And I believe that everything is getting in there. We're gonna make a copy of this. And this is gonna be a 5-5, so it's gonna be really hard for them. They kind of have to trade, and that's kind of bad because this already got me value. It's getting me even more value. Now they have to trade for it, even though it's not really a creature. They had some removal. So another grindy game, I think. I like Renan 7 against that. I don't like Ranger class on the draw once again. Snakeskin Veil looks okay. Mammoth Chariot Oddity. Can see having another Vren and maybe like a protection from removal on the draw. So boarding in some expensive cards is fine. I mean, I have 27 lands. Seems okay. Including the mana guys and Sentinel or whatever, it gets to 32, which is a lot of mana sources, honestly. Kocoure, co to tady provádíš? Hop, hop, hop. Vrr. Pack leader, yeah, expensive hand, but I could use Mammoth as a land depending on what I draw in the first turn. Or second even. Old Growth Troll. Pack leader turn one. I can even play this on turn one. I don't really necessarily need to play the pack leader, but I think it's fine. Because that still lets me decide later on this. I can play turn two without really hurting my curve. I'm extremely likely to play this as a land. Okay. Kocoure, co je? Sopa. No. Interesting. I don't think I want to trade. I could. Probably best to just play this and pass. Little stinger. Oh, that's pretty good. That's a great interaction. Is it target player? It is target player, so you can actually use it as reach. That's really cool too. I don't think I'm attacking. Pass the turn, huh? Isn't suspicious at all. When they do that thing with the with like their back kind of like in the air, that is some of the funniest stuff. I could actually attack with the troll and play Vren. But I'm kind of scared of it dying. I think it's better to just play Chariot here, honestly. You want to kill something here, that's fine. Like, if you kill this, I have extra mana. You can't kill Chariot. I guess they can counter it. This grows. Next turn, I'm going to have Chariot Crude. I can play Blizzard Brawl, play Snakeskin Veil for protection. I mean, it's extremely unlikely they don't have anything because they're not going to pass the turn with seven cards in their hand. They clearly have a removal spell at the end of the turn. I could attack. Could attack. I don't mind trading for the Stinger. Especially the Troll, because that gives me more mana. I should have done that before I played my Chariot, though. Yeah, I think attack with both is actually pretty reasonable. Sure.
It was a bad play to play this first. I didn't realize I would attack, but I think it makes sense to trade either of them for the Stinger, because that means my Chariot's gonna be able to attack. Well, they didn't actually do anything. What the hell? That's so crazy. They must be saving removal for this. I really cannot make up their hand. They either have a lot of lands or they just have removal and they decided that it's really important to kill this. But then they probably just want to blow. I don't know. I don't know what's going on in this game. I can't really play Ren because I'm going to play the Snakeskin Veil very likely. They could have two removal spells though. I mean, let's just screw this, see what happens, and then we can... I mean, maybe I do play Ren, actually. Play Ren, Crew Chariot with the token, then try to make the token a copy of it. Doesn't seem bad. Pumps this guy. What's the worst that can happen? They killed them. Oh, they killed this before it attacks. All right, whatever. I'll do it. They have two removal spells. They killed this. Oh, okay. I also didn't see that coming. We're attacking with everything. Definitely not here to block. I mean, they're going to trade for the 4-3. This pretty... Wait, what is going on? Why would they not trade for that? They have Verdict? If they had Verdict, this would block. Crippling Fear. Okay. Crippling Fear is a nice one. I wouldn't recommend attacking here. That doesn't seem like a great play. Okay, well, they tried. But this is my experience with these decks against mono green. Like when I build mono red, when I build vampires, and when I build these decks, and I'm just like excited to have Falcon Wrath, Pit Fighter, and I'm just like, oh wait, this has two power for one mana. Mono red hasn't had that in a while. And I just play against mono green, and my opponent's casting 2 mana 3/3s, 3 mana 4/4s. All right, we're back with round 3 after some technical difficulties. Great time to remind you that this video is sponsored by the Channel Fireball Marketplace, where you can find all the singles and sealed product from all your favorite local game stores. If you use the code JUZA, you can support my content as well. That is not a hand I want to keep. He does have Mammoth as a second land. That's better than going to 5. It is an awkward hand, but I mean, what can you really do? Might be better to start with the Mammoth, because if I draw another one, then I can go turn 2 Sentinel plus the tapped land, and then I'm always guaranteed to have Troll on turn 3. Yeah, let's do that. It's weird not playing the 1-drop if you have it in your opening hand, but I think it makes sense in this hand. Okay, well. Also lets you play a 2-drop on turn 2 if you draw one. So there is that. Blood that. Okay, so this is Nassif's. Ah, damn it. Nassif's Vampire deck. I don't think I want to trade. I kind of just need to draw an extra land. So I'm just going to play my 2 1-drops and pass the turn. Oh, no attacks. Thank you. Okay. Nice. So now we can either play Chariot or play Oddity. Can play also Troll and then have 2 more mana that doesn't really do much. First strike, and you get to look at the card if you deal damage. I think this is a pretty easy Chariot turn. Also bumps the pack leader. Now we can pass. Okay, so this gives them possibly a token.
This is interesting how this works. You can sacrifice the harvester that they have in play to target one of my creatures. And when the trigger resolves, before that, you get to make a blood token out of this. So even though you only have one when you activate it, you would be able to take down a 4/4. That is a pretty cool interaction. Because it checks the number of, to my understanding, it checks the number of blood tokens up on resolution. The good thing is they can never really kill the chariot with it unless I decide to block something and then do it post-combat. Because it does say a sorcery. Yep, we did not lose any life. Ranger class. So, I can play Troll, activate Chariot, and then we can smash with it. What is going to happen? If they block with Florian, we trade. That's not the worst. I have a bunch of 2/2s against their X2s. That is a good deal. Seems like a good deal to me. I can also just play Oddity. And I can attack with that too. Seems better than playing the Troll. Let's do that. So tap you and tap Cobra. I believe we're crewing like this. And we're attacking with these two bad boys. Not that. And get a token. Alright. Good token. Oh wow, I just take it? Holy crap, I didn't see that coming. What is their plan? Attack me back? I mean, that's fine. Wait, what? No attacks, no blocks? What are these cards doing? So they get to play a card for free, but I mean, my board is already big enough. I don't know if I care that much. Oh wow, that was a good draw though. That was a really good draw. It will cost them 2 life, but they will get to deal with the 4/4 trampler guy, which is a pretty big deal. Yep, that happens. That is also a pretty big deal. Okay, that explains the no attack, no block decision. And now I am properly screwed. I cannot attack. I cannot block. I think we're actually just dead. I mean, I can play Granger class, activate it, attack with Chariot. It is going to be a 5/5, but that means they're going to just double block with two creatures, and I only really trade for one Harvester, which is the same as only attacking with the Chariot. I guess that means they can block with Florian. I mean, it's better than nothing, I suppose. I could try to just swarm them eventually. Green, green. Activate you. I forgot to click on the chariot. That is unfortunate. I mean, it's not really the end of the world, because whether we trade or not really that big of a deal. But it would have been better to trade, especially since I can also play another Chariot next turn. Yeah, I would have certainly preferred to trade this off
instead of not doing that.
This is the best card in that deck, by the way. This, like, allows over all your mediocre one drops. Wow, okay. 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 All right, I see how it is. I think at this point I am kind of locked out. I have 8 attackers. And there is some world. Or maybe they get too greedy and attack a little bit too much. If I did trade these two last turn, then I play Chariot, and I believe I might actually be able to kill them because they have five blockers. And the best I can do is just add 3 more attackers into play. This turn doesn't get much better than that. Yep, that is an easy block. Sure, it doesn't matter because first strike happens first anyways. Then I play my second Chariot and kind of hope that's going to be enough. Tap you. I think they still only attack with the flyer, get an extra card, and try to kill me next turn. And we kind of have to hope that, I mean, I draw into, I don't even know if I can really draw into something. I mean, I kind of need them to break on everything, just not add another creature to play. That means they would have 6 blockers. And for that, I would need at least 10 attackers. If I could find like a +1/+1 bump spell or something. So this means I need to have 11 attackers. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Play this 11, but you know, I think we're gonna be at least one off, maybe, yeah, probably more than that. Brawl, interesting. Play back leader, bump it. Fight one creature, crew Chariot, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 9. Wait, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 11. This is dead. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 blockers. They still go to 5 life, I believe. 4 life, because it's gonna be a 2-power creature. Yeah, well, I think not trading the Chariot there. No, it won't cost me exactly. Oh, wait, I don't even have 3 snow permanents. Never mind. This doesn't work as well as I thought. Yeah, I'm dead. Oh, well. Yeah, I don't have three Snowpermans. This doesn't work. Okay. What are my worst cards? I don't love Ranger class. I definitely don't like it on the draw. On the play, it's maybe okay to leave in a few. But if you're going to cut something, Ranger class is definitely one of the easier cuts. I don't think Snakeskin Veil is particularly great. They will have a lot of removal though. One is okay, just to keep them honest. Oddity is actually okay on the play. On the draw, I might want to board into like some Vrenin 7s. I think I want to keep it like this. Gotsore. The Wonder. Another awkward hand that we have to mulligan. I don't think you can keep that. This is just not a reasonable keep in this deck. There's just too many expensive cards, unfortunately. Out of this hand, I'm going to throw away the Blizzard Brawl. How does it look without this? Sentinel into class. If I throw away this, that seems crazy. I go Mammoth into class, into nothing. If I throw away you, that seems even worse. I could throw this away and just go Mammoth into class, into activate class. And just have Blizzard Brawl in hand. This is a pretty bad card. It's either Brawl, and then I have a pretty good opener. Yeah, let's just throw away Brawl. I boarded in some extra removal. On the play, I can afford to be just more aggressive depending on the card I draw. Oof. I guess, okay, that actually works. That lets me play Chariot next turn, so that's fine. Because I can play Mammoth. Yeah, that actually works. All right. Play Mammoth, get one mana. 2/3, tap these two, play Chariot. Okay. I will definitely not block. Okay, now I don't even need to play the Mammoth. That is great. I actually kind of don't mind trading off the Cobra. They are a synergy deck. The more vampires they have in play, the better for them. I'll keep it around. Keep it around. I'm not gonna trade it for one drop. Like, extra mana is still good for me. Like, I can put it into the Ranger class. Like, that's not irrelevant. Okay. This is not supposed to be that great against Mono Green. Like, my creatures are so much bigger. It just happened that. Oh, it works so well against what I have right now. I think I still activate this, right? Wow, that is really unfortunate. What are you gonna do? If I draw a land, I can play Mammoth, Landfall, crew this, but the problem is I don't have anything to copy. I would be able to do that next turn though. So yeah, it is still Mammoth, Land, crew you. Attack for four. Next, I play Ranger class. That gives me a token to copy. Tap both, crew this. I can activate this as well. That'd be a 5/5. Let's see what they have. Okay, a braid's good. Okay. Or got exiled? Creature, sure. Ooh. Well, that is better than Ranger class, for sure. I take two, but I attack for seven. No, that sounds good to me. Didn't have to attack with the mammoth, but I think being aggressive here is good. Because the more aggressive I am, the less aggressive they can be. Yep, I don't think that's going to be good enough here. Whoa. Are they just dead on board? What the hell? That's a good one. That is a good one. I mean, this is trampled. They need to have something. Am I missing something? This is first strike. This doesn't. So they can... I guess they can chump. Okay, let's see. Stack with both, see what happens. Keep mana for the inscription. I could play the Ranger class and activate it, and then have two lethal attackers. That's also not unreasonable. But I think keeping mana open is probably better, like in case they have like another abrade or something for the mammoth. I think this is also a fine play. They still have to chump, right? They can't block. They can double block this because then they take trample damage, so. Okay, no, that's good. I'm not gonna force the issue with the inscription, I don't think. There's the abrade. Okay, so we did successfully play around that. Deal three is okay. I can make it bigger. That's a 6 power creature and 6 toughness, and it's taking 5 first strikes. So yeah, if I do this, we are fine. We can fight. Put 2 creatures, but the counters is probably the best. There's multiple ways to do it. I can fight these two, and then they take 4 trample. Which is a million ways to do it. Wow, even through the big blowout with the vampire thing, we were able to take that game on a mulligan. Oddity was actually good. Like, I think that's going to be better than Ren and 7. The problem with Ren is they kind of just flood the board with little creatures, and if they just kill the token, it's pretty easy to then just kill you. So I think I just won the extra Oddity. I don't think Snakeskin Veil is what real... it wasn't that bad, actually. But, Ranger class is pretty bad on the draw, especially if they have the 2 damage to everything card. Maybe I'll just have another Snakeskin Veil. Might have too many instances and sorceries now. But let's see how that serves us. One drop, 2 drop. Yeah, that's good. I like it. I like this hand. I quite like this hand. Interesting. Turn 2. Definitely don't want to trade these two. I will play my pack leader and pass.
I have to say, I'm a little less excited about this than I was when I first saw it. It's still kind of like, it's not a bad creature. It's really good against control. That's the biggest thing. But against other creature decks, oh yeah, you think I'm going to block with this and you're going to deal two to every creature? That's not going to happen. I mean, I could block with this. That actually wouldn't be bad because now they can play the 3-3 Vampire, but this is also fine. Here it comes. This dies. They take three. Oh, a brain. Okay, that works too, I guess. But it really kind of gives away what they have if they attack with the 1-1 into the 3-3. Because I don't really think there's anything else. It is going to change how I play. Because normally I would play the Chariot, but I think now I just play the Oddity. Because Chariot just plays right into the Sweeper. Like, everything dies. Sure, I keep my Chariot, but I don't really have any tokens left. I don't really have anything to crew it with other than the Trample guy, but that has haste, so kind of want to do it like this. Sure, that's fine. If we're trading creatures one for one with removal, then that suits mono green. Because your creatures are better against this stuff, thanks to Chariot, thanks to Old Growth Drill. You have Faceless Haven. And I still think one of the cards in their hand is the deal 2 to every known vampire. Is this when you play it? Whenever you cast. I could cast this. This gets bigger. And they can only kill the tokens with it. That's interesting. What we can do, I can attack with the Faceless Haven and see if they block and then try to play the sweeper, because this is a vampire. So they might be thinking, I'm going to deal one to it and then I'm going to play the sweeper and it's going to die. Well, that wouldn't happen. But I think it's fine if I play Chariot here and just don't attack with this. Or attack with this first. I think that's the best way to do it, actually. I probably should have boarded in some Renin 7s, considering how much removal they have. This is a thing where if you see their deck list, you would be able to make a better decision. All right, there we go. If I played this first, this would have been a 4-3, then they block with this guy, and then they played the sweeper, so it would have died along with the token. So attacking first lets me deal 3 and then not to risk the creature dying. Surprise, surprise. Had they not attacked with the 1-1 into my 3-3, they probably could have gotten a lot more value out of it. We are really not drawing pretty well. I think I actually want a crew Chariot here, because if they're going to kill something, I would prefer them killing the Chariot rather than my Faceless Haven here. Because Chariot without creatures is not really that useful. Sure. And now I still have a Faceless Haven. They have not been activating this, which is really strange. Holy crap, how many lands are we gonna draw? Well, that is unfortunate. I mean, this has to be another removal spell. If they're not activating the blood gems, like, what else would they be saving in their hand if it's not a creature? Oh, wait. I could have blocked with this. Well, it's really should have blocked the 1-1, even though, I mean, it would have probably died to the removal, so it doesn't really matter, but it would have been better to do that. This is really crazy to me. What do they have? I mean, it has to be a removal spell, right? Like, what can they possibly have? Like, another awakening would make sense, maybe? I mean, even this sounds like a card you would probably rather trade for something new. If you're going to play this, it's probably better to attack first and then get an extra counter. They didn't activate the harvest on the troll. I am very confused as to what is happening. I just think they have to have a removal spell. That's why I'm not playing the Blizzard Brawl. Might be wrong, but I just don't think they can possibly not have it. Maybe I'm just giving them too much credit. Maybe they just have a land there forgetting that they can activate this. Who knows? Okay, well, that's fine. Okay. Okay. Well, I guess. Wow. I don't know what to do now. Whew. I mean, I'll just pass. I don't need to kill the Harvester. It's only as a sorcery though, right? No, you can do it at any time, okay. I'm saving it in case they have something like Anya, like the 4-5, that I would want to attack through. Okay, they transform into something else. Yep. I'm at 6. They can't play Infernal Grasp. A Bray doesn't kill it. So it has to be Power Word kill. Or a big creature. A big creature I can kill. So that's not a big deal. Oh, they did have Infernal Grasp. There we go. Seeker's Chariot. So we can attack first. See what happens. Okay. Yeah, that's why I don't think this card is that great, because Mono Green just has... The creatures are just too big. I mean, sure, you can bring it in, but then you can't really give it away that you have it by just attacking your 1-1 to a 3-3 on turn 3. Was it this game? Or was it a different game? Might have been this game. Wow, they had a lot of removal. If I knew that, if I knew their list, I probably would have brought in the Wrens. We drew so many lands, and we still won pretty easily. I guess they didn't... Well, not easily, but... They didn't really have a lot of pressure, that was a thing. But then they should have been activating these earlier. Like, why are you keeping cards you can't cast? I don't know, this was a weird game, but we drew 10 lands. But we'll take it. Yep, thanks for watching. That was Mono Green. You know, one of the top 5 decks in Standard, for sure. But I don't know, I think still the Izzet decks are probably slightly better. It's just every time I play against Izzet, I'm just like, wow, I wish I was the one drawing all these cards and playing all these, you know, busted cards and taking these extra turns and bouncing your spells to your hand. I don't know. It just seems still like the best deck to me in Standard. But Mono Green is still not, you know, not that far behind. Definitely got upgraded. Yeah, thanks for watching. I will see you next time.